Hello everyone. Okay, so let's begin today's video, that is the second part of our topic number towards independence and the partition, right? So we have completed this topic, half of this topic till this paragraph, right? Muslims still supported it, and from the next paragraph we are going to complete the chapter in this video, and in the next video we are going to cover these brown boxes, light brown orange type of boxes, color type of boxes. Okay, we will cover them also, but in today's we are going to complete almost of the chapter. Okay, so let's begin. First of all, I want to tell you there is a term, general constituencies. So basically, let me begin. Okay, in the last video, what we studied about, that Congress felt, Muslim League felt very alone. They felt that, you know, that somehow they are being resisted, they are being stopped by Congress leaders, by Britishers, because Britishers were supporting, at that time, they were supporting the Congress leaders. So a lot of people tried to convince Muslim League, but Muslim League did not get convinced and just stood on their point. Okay, but now, the next thing is, after 1937, this was the in the last video we studied till the time period of 1946, when in 1945 the war, Second World War, ended, right? After that, in 1946, elections to the provinces were again held in 1946. Okay, Congress did well in the general constituencies. Now, I'll explain you what is general constituencies. Otherwise, in your book, the term is mentioned election districts with no reservations for any religious or other community. Okay, so I'll explain. Here you see, okay. So, in the earlier times, the Indian map was kind of this type. And these are 1946 states shaded by largest party. Okay. So there is Indian National Congress with blue color. Here you can see there is a lot of blue color in the map. Then the green color shows the All India Muslim League Party. And Muslim League also won a lot of main provinces, and their success was spectacular in your book. Okay. So actually their success was spectacular because they covered almost of the areas like Bengal, Punjab, Sindh. It is good thing, right? INC was also big party, also a large party compared to the All India Muslim League. Okay, so in these elections, 1946 elections, All India Muslim League also won, and a lot of places Indian National Congress also won. But Indian National Congress had a huge success in general constituencies. Now, what are general constituencies? These were the general constituencies. Now, what were the general constituencies is basically constituencies. First, the term constituency. Constituency refers to an area which is for the voters. Okay. Means an area which has voters who will elect a representative in that area to the legislative assembly. Okay. Simple definition it is. So these constituencies, India was divided into different constituencies, and general constituencies are those constituencies which doesn't have any reserved seats, which doesn't have any kind of reservation for any party, such as in 1909 Muslims gave reservation in the parliament to Muslim League. Okay, because they supported in the Bengal partition, that is why they gave this to Muslim League. When this was given to Muslim League, at that time, Muslim had some reserved seats. Since then, they have reserved seats in the parliament for Muslim League, All India Muslim League. Okay. Now, these were the constituencies here. Okay. Now, let's come to the next thing. So, now, Pakistan was again on its demand of getting Pakistan. Okay. Means Muslim League was persisted with its demand to get Pakistan. Now, in March 1946, what happened? In this month of this year, British cabinet sent a three-member mission to Delhi. Okay, and this was basically three intellectual Britishers who came to Delhi to resolve the issue of partition, that India should be parted or be united. So for that, this three-member mission came and they suggested that India should be united and give some autonomy, or you can say independence, freedom to the Muslim League, and the Muslim majority areas should can have their own rules, can have their own ideas, or can have a little changes compared to the other parts of India which has more Hindu majority areas. Okay, so they suggested this, and they suggested a loose confederation with some autonomy. Means loose confederation means confederation is just an alliance or a group or unity, or you can say, a simple alliance. Okay, so alliance is just that, it is loose alliance, means the alliance which has not that, which is not that strong and firm, that India will not be that strong unity. So for that, Britishers, this was the suggestion of Britishers, which wasn't accepted by neither Congress leaders nor Muslim League. Okay, so partition was now like sure to happen, that it will happen anyhow. Maybe it is a better way or a bad way or a worse way, it doesn't matter, but it has to happen anyhow. This is the only solution of this problem. Okay, now let's get to the next thing here. When this cabinet mission was failed to convince Muslim League finally decided on mass agitation. Okay, mass agitation. Agitation means in Hindi it is Andolan. Okay, so Andolan, mass agitation for a group of people who will, they decided to win their Pakistan demand anyhow by any cost. Okay, so it announced 16th August 1946 as the direct action day. Okay, as the direct action day. So this day was announced as direct action day, 16th August 1946. Learn it, definitely gonna come in your exams. On this day, riots broke out in Calcutta, lasting several days and resulting in the death of thousands of people. Okay, so now riots broke out means riots began from Calcutta until March 1946. This violence, these riots spread throughout the northern India. Okay, and in this, a lot of people were killed, numberless women were, they faced untold brutalities during the partition. Untold brutalities means the cruel actions which can't even be said to someone, which can't even can be expressed in words. That cruelty has happened to the women at that time during the partition. Millions of people were forced to leave their homes and torn asunder from their homelands. Torn asunder means, like, you have seen a paper. When we tear a paper, it is like something, if it is a paper and we tear it from here. So these parts, this is, right? So this is torn and apart. Asunder means apart, okay? So the people from their homelands, like this is people and these are homelands, they were so apart from that and they faced it, and it is very difficult to leave their homes. They were reduced to being refugees in alien lands. The lands, they didn't even know people, they didn't even live there, they didn't even watch the vegetation and what's all. They didn't know anything, but still. And partition doesn't mean that Pakistan or India and India people riots, doesn't mean this only. It means that India got changed. India has cities of India has changed. A new country, Pakistan, has born. A new country, India, has born with different boundaries. So the joy of our country's independence. So the joy of our country's independence from British rule came mixed with the pain and the violence of partition. Okay, so this is how things were, that even after having independence, India was not that happy because partition has held and a lot of people suffered through it. And this was the worst that could ever happen. This was the worst ending, actually. Okay? So that is all in your chapter. I hope you got it. If you have any kind of question or doubt related to this, please mention in the comment section. I'll definitely answer. And also, if you like it, or dislike it. Bye.